of her money. And then finally she came to her senses and she said, you know what, I've tried all these doctors. Now I need to try Dr. Jesus. Amen. And so she knew that she had to make her way to him. And once she made her way to the doctor, he didn't even have to touch her. But she touched the hem of his garment and she was made whole. So even when you're going through the storm, the physical sickness, I want you to know that the God that I serve is able to step into that physical sickness storm and he can turn that storm around. He can say, peace be still, and that storm must disappear. Many of you are sitting here today and you're saying, well, Pastor, I don't have a physical sickness storm. I don't have that. Well, what about that domestic storm? What is that domestic storm? If home, sweet home, is no longer home, sweet home, and it's now home, sad home, you're in a domestic storm. Amen. Friction between the husband and the wife. There may be friction between the parents and the kids. There may be friction between the brothers and the sisters. But whatever it is a domestic storm. Amen. Now, we know that there are many things that take place in life. We see and we hear about so many murders. I hear about drive-bys on the news from time to time, and they just ride by into the crowds and they shoot into the crowds, taking innocent lives. And it is such a shame that life is of no use anymore. Life is just worthless now to many people, and they'll kill people at the drop of a dime. But I'm here to tell you that if you study and you look at the statistics, there are more people that are killed in domestic storms than there is in any other type of storm. Amen. We see the husbands killing the wives, or the children even killing the parents now. You know, life is just worthless. And maybe it's because, you know, sometimes there's friction because child custody that's going on, and there's things about divorces. One doesn't want to leave the other. There's also times when they just argue for some things that doesn't even make sense. There are times when they argue about those things that once made them laugh and once made them smile. Maybe a certain flaw that the other one had, but in the beginning you thought it was cute. And now that same thing that made you laugh before now begins to make you cry. It begins to make you sad and it begins to make you angry. Sometimes there may be one that's concerned that there is a third party extracurricular activities going on, you know, on the intimate level. And they just can't seem to work things out. And, you know, families just don't pray anymore. There used to be a saying where they would say, families that pray together stay together. Amen? Amen. And so we see that this is going on. But, you know, many times you try to handle the situation on your own. But, neighbor, you cannot battle this storm on your own. Amen. It is time to call Jesus. Amen? Amen. Some of you are saying right now, well, Pastor, I don't have a domestic storm. Yes. I don't have a domestic storm. Well, what about that financial storm? Yes. That storm where it seems like you have more bills than you have money. Yes. And every paycheck to paycheck, you're switching bills and you're trying to put one ahead of the other, and you're saying, well, if I pay this one, this check, I'll pay the next one on the next check, and things are just going bad for you. Seems like every dollar that you get, it has to leave, and you have to spend it on something, and you just don't have anything to give, amen? And then you may hear the pastor or the apostle up here speaking, and they say to you, you know, you need to be giving tithing and offerings unto God. And you're saying, to yourself, how can I give tithing and offering? And I got all these bills, I'm tied up, I can't do anything. And you want to come up and you want to kick the apostle in his leg and slap him and say, I can't give no money, what's wrong with you? But it's because we know that you can't do it alone. But when you give God the first fruits of your increase and you give him your partnership dues.
Say that, sir.
God will step in into that financial storm and he will calm that raging sea. He will bring down those raging waves and he will make a way for you and he'll bring you out of situations financially that you never thought you could be brought out of. Amen?
Amen. Yes, it will.
Oh, there are many storms. There's storms of addiction, amen, that's going on and we try to handle it on ourselves, amen. Drugs and alcohol addictions and there's sex addictions, pornography addictions. But yet I just want you to know that I serve a God who is able to step in any storm and he'll say to you, no matter what you're going through, I can calm down the raging sea. Just like when they were on the ship going across, Jesus said to them, it's time for us to go on the other side. I've done my work over here on this side. Sail out across the sea. The Bible says that immediately there was a great storm. Jesus was tired, so he went down to the hidden part of the ship and he was taking a nap. Now the disciples, they tried to battle the storm all by themselves. Was flashing, the thunder was rolling, the waves were growing. They tried and they tried, and then they said to themselves, oh, now we can't do it by ourselves. So somebody said, I think it's time to go wake up Jesus. Oh, Lord, now I don't know who it was that went to wake him up. It has often been said that it was Simon Peter that went down to wake him up. But he went down to wake him up and he said, Master, oh Master, do you care that we perish? He said to the Master, he said, the wind is howling like a wild pack of wolves. The lightning is doing a limbo dance across the Ethiopian skies. Lord, the thunder sounds like a bunch of cannons crashing on us. And the waves are calm, they look like tsunamis. And they crash it into the ship and filling it up. The ship is being tossed and thrown like a little red dog. He walked out to the brow of the ship and he said, peace, be still. And the wind ceased. The waves laid down like a little baby in his mother's arms. Oh, Lord. And then he said, why are you so fearful? Oh, ye of no faith. Oh, Lord. Something storm in me.